Salutations, Celestial Sightseers, David Fuller with Eyes on the Sky. I had purchased this Meade Schmidt Cassegrain telescope earlier this year, and it's got really nice optics. And I got it for a song, which was great. And I'm hoping to be able to defork it, because I think I'm going to be able to get better use out of it if I have it on an equatorial mount as opposed to the fork mount. Because the fork mount, as I discovered years ago, is difficult to use when you want to try to look at things, especially to the north, for example. So if you want to try to do this and look towards the North Star or anything that direction, you can see where the eyepiece and star diagonal end up, and that makes it very difficult to be able to view stuff, especially if things are through here and you're trying to look at stuff that's overhead. Yeah, you can push this around through here, but there's still just difficult places that make it hard to be able to do this, whereas on a German equatorial mount, you have a much wider ability to be able to aim the telescope wherever you want and have an eyepiece at a comfortable level. So I'm going to try to see if I can defork this and see how that works. One of the things that a couple of things I've already actually accomplished with this telescope, and let me lock this in place, is I have already put on the dovetail bar. I did manage to get that, along with a handle that straps all the way around, and I've already put it underneath the bar right here. You can see it already goes underneath. So that way I'll be able to pick up the telescope and hold it securely using this strap. I'll put this back down so you can see this. So there's the strap. So I'd be able to just hold that easily, pick up the whole tube, and have it more securely with one hand as opposed to always having to carry it with two. Especially in the dark, that's something that's kind of helpful to have as an option. So here's a look at the inside of this. Pretty optics, they look beautiful. The gentleman who had this before me kept it in very good shape. And I see that there's a screw, wow, missing out of my, yikes, corrector plate. I guess I need to fix that, because that would be a problem, wouldn't it? Glad I found that. Anyway, we'll see if we can get these sides off and start being able to undo the fork itself, or the tube from the fork. And I guess one other thing I should mention. The tripod for this is not the original Meade tripod. It is a somewhat thin tube, lightweight, I believe, Criterion tripod, which does actually have a pretty stable base on it. However, it's a little lightweight, which means the whole thing is very top heavy. Not crazy about that. I prefer a little bit more weight down, especially when things are windy. So although this works relatively well for visual observing, for astrophotography, it's probably not going to be what I want to be able to do, especially since, you know, I can have an eyepiece at least through the back here, but no way to be able to put a camera on there. So fork has to go, and we'll see how we can get the tube to work elsewhere. Well, I worked on taking off one of the fork arms because the way that you take this apart is not what I thought. I thought maybe you took off this plate and there was something under there. No, not so much. What you actually do is you wind up taking two Allen screws out, but then you can't get to the other one without actually removing the arm. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you what I have to do on this one, because this one I actually have to remove the declination motor as well. By the way, what you really wanna have in your toolkit for astronomy is both imperial as well as metric Allen wrenches, because oh my gosh, they are all over this thing, and you'll find a lot of Allen screws in all kinds of other stuff when it has to do with astronomy related equipment. They use a lot of them. So, and I've used probably six so far just on this, so it helps to have a whole lot. You can get these at like Harbor Freight for, I don't know, $8 or something like that. It wasn't very expensive, so definitely worth investing in. All right, so let's see what we can do here. So the reason I have to remove the declination motor is that there's a screw here and a screw here, but then there's two more behind where the motor's actually mounted. So that's the only way to get to those screws, to be able to pull this out enough that I can get to the third screw that's back behind that section of the arm to be able to remove this so that the tube comes free. had to remove the spur gear or the pinion gear. I'm putting these screws back into the housing of the declination motor, that way I do not lose them. You never know when you want to refork a Schmidt Cassegrain telescope. And you don't want to lose this, because this is, can't replace this stuff easily. I'm sure I could find other screws, but I don't want to have to look, because it's a lot easier to just have it in where it needs to be. I'm going to tighten up that pinion gear so I don't lose that either. All right, that's that. Now, this is where these are. Now, what I found on the other side was that these are really difficult to get started because I don't have a lot of leverage to get that going. So I took a socket with an extension, put it on the end of the Allen key, and then break it free. Makes it much easier. And then it spins easily. So you can see how the base comes loose. This is the right ascension. Motor drive section, so that's completely loose and free. Now the arm is not free yet, because I can still only get to those two, but with that pulled out, I can now get the Allen key in there. And I couldn't get it in there before because there wasn't enough room. I could have ground down the Allen key and made it shorter, but then I have a tool that's shorter that I have to use for everything else. I didn't want to do that, so this was actually better, even though it took a little bit more time. So I think I lost some things. I'm not sure where it stopped because I haven't gone to check yet, but I know that it stopped and my camera stopped and I ran out of video space. So I made some space. And what I do want to show you is that I removed the declination motor from this arm and then removed this arm in order to be able to get the small Allen key in between this arm and the actual telescope itself, which then freed up this telescope. So now I have a deforked LX50 Schmidt Cassegrain telescope, which I can put on a German equatorial mount and be able to take photos and do visual astronomy and hopefully share some of those photos with you too as I start getting better at that. But importantly, I've got it free from this so I can start to get some better tracking and do some of those things. So thanks for watching. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. And please hit the like and subscribe buttons. I would appreciate that. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.